हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट द कंपोजिशन ऑफ द टू एसएचएम हैविंग सेम टेम्परेट ट्रैवल ऑन द सेम पाथ। देयरफॉर टू डिस्कस अबाउट दिस पॉइंट लेट अस कंसीडर द डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ द पार्टिकल एट द हैविंग एम्पलीट्यूड ए1 एंड ए2। लेट अस कंसीडर द टू डिस्प्लेसमेंट टू एसएचएम travel along the same path having same time period with different amplitude and with different initial phase. It travels subjected to the simultaneously, and when these two SSM combine together, then we get the resultant displacement, and resultant displacement is the vector sum of these two SSM having same time period and travel along the same path. It travel with along the positive x direction. Therefore, the displacement of particle, having amplitude a1 and phase phi 1, it is given by x1 is equal to a1 sin omega t plus phi 1. Say this equation number 1. Let us consider this equation number 1. Then another displacement having amplitude a2 and phase phi 2, it is given by, say this equation number 2. When these two SHM simultaneously takes place, then resultant displacement is the vector sum of these two displacement. Therefore, x is equal to x1 plus x2. Resultant displacement, x is the resultant displacement, is the displacement of these two SHM. Let us consider this equation number 3. By putting this value of 1 and 2, put 1 and 2 in 3, we get. Therefore, x is equal to a1 sin omega t plus phi 1, omega t plus phi 1 plus a2 sin omega t plus phi 2. Then by using formula that is sin a plus sin b sin a plus b is equal to sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. By using this formula for this expression, that is sin a plus b is equal to sin a cos b cos a sin b. By using this mathematics formula for this sin omega t plus phi 1 and say a2 sin omega t plus phi 1. Therefore, equation becomes x is equal to a1 in bracket sin omega t into cos phi 1 plus cos omega t into sin phi 1 plus, for this equation we can use also this formula. Therefore, equation becomes a2 sin omega t, a2 sin omega t into cos phi 2 plus cos omega t plus cos omega t into sin phi 2. By using this formula we can write here, then multiply this a1 in the bracket and a2 in the bracket. Therefore, equation becomes, we can write here, a1 sin omega t into cos phi 1 plus a 1 cos omega t into sin phi 1 plus multiply this a 2 in this bracket, therefore a 2 sin omega t into sin omega t cos phi 2 plus a 2 cos omega t or cos omega t into sin phi. Then sin omega t taken common from this equation, therefore also cos omega t taken outside, therefore expression become sin omega t in bracket, remaining terms are a1 cos phi 1 plus a2 cos phi plus cos omega t in bracket a1 sin phi 1 plus a2 sin phi. We get here we have to put r cos delta, it is equal to this term, that is a1 cos phi 1, it is a1 cos phi 1 plus a2 cos phi 2, a2 cos phi 2. Then r sin delta, it is equal to put a1 sin phi 1 plus a2 sin phi 2. Put this value, say this equation number 4, put this value of equation 5 in 4, put this value of equation 5 in 4, therefore x become x is equal to sin omega t in bracket sin omega t into r cos delta plus cos omega t into r sin delta. Taking r outside, therefore we get x is equal to in bracket sin omega t into cos delta plus cos omega t into sin delta. R is taken outside, therefore expression becomes x is equal to r sin omega t cos delta plus cos omega t sin delta. Therefore this is the formula of this equation, that is sin a plus b, that is sin a cos b cos a sin b, sin a cos b cos a sin b. Therefore expression become x is equal to r in bracket sin r sin omega t plus delta. Let us consider this equation number 6. This equation represent resultant displacement of that particle at any instant when two simple harmonic motion combine together, then we get this resultant displacement of the two SHM having amplitude resultant amplitude r and resultant phase delta. Here we get expression of displacement of particle having amplitude r and resultant displacement is x, resultant amplitude is r and resultant phase is delta. After that we can calculate here the value of resultant amplitude. To find resultant amplitude, that is capital R, we have to take the two expressions, that is R sin delta r sin delta is equal to a1 sin phi 1 plus a2 sin phi 2 and r cos delta that is a1 cos phi 1 plus a2 cos phi 2. These two expressions are taken and these two expressions are squaring and adding on both sides. These two expressions are taken to calculate the resultant amplitude r and these two equations are squaring and adding on both sides of equation we get. Therefore, expression become r square sin square delta plus r square cos square delta. It is equal. First term is taken here. Therefore, we can calculate here a1 sin phi 1 plus a2 sin phi 2 bracket square plus a2 cos phi 1 a2 cos phi 1 plus a2 cos phi 2 bracket square. Therefore, expression become we can write here that is r sin delta is equal to a1 sin phi 1 plus a2 sin phi 2 and r cos delta it is equal to a1 cos phi 1 plus a2 cos phi 2. To find the resultant amplitude, let us consider these two equations and these two equations are squaring and adding these two equations. Therefore, equation become that is r square sin square delta plus r square cos square delta. These two expressions are squaring and adding. Therefore, expression become that is a1 sin phi 1 plus a2 sin phi 2 bracket square plus a1 cos phi 1 plus a2 cos phi 2 bracket square. By solving this bracket, then r square is taken outside. Therefore, remaining term is sin square delta plus cos square delta. Squaring on both sides, that is a1 square sin square phi 1 plus 2a1 a2 sin phi 1 into sin phi 2 plus a2 square sin square phi 2 plus a1 square cos square phi 1 plus 2a1 a2 cos of phi 1 cos of phi 2 cos of phi 2 plus a2 square cos square phi 2. Then here r square sin square delta plus cos square delta, that is sin square delta and cos square delta, it is plus cos square delta, it is equal to 1. Therefore, r square is equal to, we can write here, taking a1 square common, an equation become, therefore a1 square common, therefore sin square phi 1 plus cos square phi 1. After that a2 square, 2a1 a2, this is taken common, therefore expression become 2a1 a2 sin of phi 1 sin of phi 1 into sin phi 2 plus cos of phi 1 cos of phi 2 cos of phi 1 cos of phi 2. Then after that we can take an a2 square common, therefore expression become a2 square sin square phi 2 plus cos square phi 2. Here also sin square phi 1 and cos square phi 1 and sin square phi 2 and cos square phi 2, it is equal to 1. It is equal to 1. Therefore expression become, we can write here, that is, here we can write sin square delta, it is equal to 1. Therefore after that we can writing r square, sin square delta cos square delta, it is equal to 1. Also this sin square phi 1 cos square phi 1, it is equal to 1. Sin square phi 2, it is equal to 1. Therefore r square, here r square, it is equal to a1 square into 1 plus 2a1 a2 in bracket, this formula of, this is the formula of cos of alpha 1 minus alpha 2, that is cos a minus b is equal to, we know that mathematics formula, that is cos a minus b, cos a minus b, it is equal to sin a sin b plus cos a cos b. By using this formula we can write here, that is cos of alpha 1 minus alpha 2 plus a2 square, because that is, since sin square phi 1 plus cos square phi 1, it is equal to 1. Therefore expression become r square into a1 square 1 plus 2a1 into cos of alpha 1 minus alpha 2. Therefore we can write here r is equal to, we can write here expression become r is equal to, in bracket r square is equal to a1 square plus 2a1 a2 into cos of alpha 1 minus alpha 2 plus a2 square. Therefore r is equal in square root, we can write here a1 square plus a2 square plus 2a1 a2 cos of in bracket alpha 1 minus alpha 2. This is the formula of resultant amplitude. This is the formula of resultant amplitude here. Therefore this is the resultant amplitude and a phase, initial phase, that is alpha 1 minus alpha 2. After that we can discuss about that cases of the resultant amplitude, and cases is that there are three cases. First case, if these two SHM are in phase, therefore expression become, we know that resultant amplitude, it is given by, we know that expression we get here, r is equal to in bracket a1 square plus a2 square plus 2a1 a2 cos of alpha 1 minus alpha 2. We can get here expression. And there are three cases. At first, we discuss about the first case. That is, first case is if phase difference or that is alpha 1 minus alpha 2, it is equal to 0, that is it is in phase, therefore expression become r, we can write r is equal to a1 square plus a2 square plus 2a1 a2 cos of alpha 1 minus alpha 2 is 0, therefore cos 0 is 1, cos 0 is 1, therefore we get expression here a1 square plus a2 square plus 2a1 a2 into 1, and this is the square of which term, a plus b square, therefore expression we can write here a plus a1 plus a2 square, this is the square of a1 plus a2 square, therefore square and square root cancel here, therefore expression r is equal to a1 plus a2. We get resultant amplitude when two SSM are in phase, then we get r is equal to a1 plus a2. If there are two amplitudes, if a1 is equal to a2, case of if there is two amplitudes are equal, that is a1 is equal to a2, then we can write a2 is equal to, that is a1 plus a2 is equal to a1 plus a2 is equal to, we can write here a plus a, that is r is equal to 2a, r is equal to 2a. After that we can discuss about second case. This is the first case second is if phase difference alpha 1 minus alpha 2, we can write if phase is 90, that is alpha 1 minus alpha 2 is equal to pi by 2, that is then expression become r is equal to, we can write expression a1 square plus a2 square plus 2a1 a2 cos of pi by 2. Cos 90 it is equal to 0, therefore expression we can write here, expression is a1 square plus a2 square plus 2a1 a2 into 0, therefore expression we can write here, that is a1 plus a2 square it is equal to 0, therefore we can get here a1 square plus a2 square, this is the resultant amplitude when phase is pi by 2. If there is case of equal amplitude, a1 plus a2 is equal to a, then r is equal to, we can get here a1 square a square plus a square, that is in bracket 2a square, therefore square root of 2 into we get. If there is case of equal amplitude, then we get square root of 2a. This is the two cases are discussed. After that, third case is we can take on here alpha 1 minus alpha 2. We can take on the two cases, that is alpha 1 minus alpha 2. 0, pi by 2, after that we can discuss about, that is 180 degree or pi, alpha 1, if phase difference are taken 180 degree or pi, then we can write here in this equation pi, cos pi, but cos pi here is minus 1, therefore we can get here, by putting these all values in this equation, a1 square plus a2 square, 2a1 a2 cos of pi, cos pi is here minus 1, therefore we get here expression a1 minus a2 square, because here also change plus a1 a2, it is we get here expression r is equal to, that is a1 square plus a2 square minus 2a1 a2 due to this minus 1, and after that we get r is equal to a1 minus a2 square minus c is taken here, square and square root cancel, therefore we get here r is equal to a1 minus a2. If there is case of equal amplitude, that is a1 a2 is equal to a, case of equal amplitude, then a1 minus a2, therefore we can get here a minus a, therefore we can get here resultant amplitude r is equal to 0, r is equal to 0. This is the resultant, this is about the resultant amplitude. After that we can, here we can discuss about the cases of the resultant amplitude, also case of equal amplitude, how can it obtain, we can discuss about that. After that we can discuss about the initial phase, that is resultant phase of SHM. For that purpose we have to consider also expression of, we can consider the expression of that is R taken, that is R sine delta is equal to A1 sine phi 1 plus A2 sine phi 2 and R cos delta, it is equal to A1 cos phi 1 plus A2 cos phi 2. These two expressions are taken. Say this number to find resultant phase of 2SHM. Consider these two equation. Say this equation number 1 and 2. Then divide this equation. Divide equation 1 by 2 we get. 1 by 2 we get. Therefore, expression become R sine delta divided by R cos delta is equal to A1 sine phi 1 plus A2 sine phi 2 divided by A1 cos phi 1 plus A2 cos phi 2. Here RR get cancelled, and we know that sine divided by cos, it is the tan delta, therefore expression A1 sine phi 1 plus A2 sine phi 2 divided by A1 cos phi 1 plus A2 cos phi 2. After that, just transfer this tan, therefore we get the expression delta is equal to tan inverse of A1 sine phi 1 plus A2 sine phi 2 divided by A1 cos phi 1 plus A2 cos phi 2. This is the resultant phase of simple harmonic motion. In this lecture we are discuss about the resultant displacement as well as resultant amplitude and resultant phase of 2SHM. Thank you very much.